they discovered what they believed to be a dead soldier and left him to concentrate on the rest of the paratroopers. However, John was very much alive and was rescued later in the day. At 5 o'clock, the 505th Parachute Regiment, led by Lieutenant Colonel Edward Krauser and Lieutenant Turner Turnbull, finally took the town. The Germans counterattacked in the afternoon, but were eventually repelled by the US troops when reinforced by tanks rolling off Utah Beach on the 7th of June. The museum in St. Mary Glees is home to hundreds of artifacts from the Second World War. Many of these have been donated by the veterans or have been recovered from the battlefields. They give us an insight into what life was like back then. Utah Beach was the most western of the landing beaches and were invaded by the US 8th Infantry Division, who found their landing on the Utah Beach to be comparatively easier than on Omaha. The landings took place at 06:30, and like the other beaches, the troops were off their assigned sectors due to the currents and resistance from the shoreline. Brigadier General Theodore Roosevelt led the initial assault. Knowing that his forces were off target, he led a reconnaissance party to find the causeways off the beach. He then coordinated with the other commanders a new battle plan, and this went very successfully. For his efforts, Roosevelt was awarded the Medal of Honor. Over 23,000 men had landed at the end of the day, with 200 losses. This figure has been accredited to the lack of German defenses in the main, and also the efforts of the Screaming Eagles of the 101st Airborne Division, who had landed in the early hours of June 6, and had through the night engaged the enemy forces, causing widespread disruption to the German defences, led by Karl Wilhelm von Schlieben and Dietrich Kreis.